So science really fundamentally is about discovery. I mean, that's what excites me every day when I get up. I come into work and I know that I'm going to be working on something that's new and interesting, and in all likelihood, it's going to lead to more and more questions. I'm really passionate about nature and trying to understand the connections between life on Earth and what really defines where we find life on Earth. Biodiversity can be described as the variation in species or species attributes, and geodiversity is described as the variation in the physical processes and also patterns on the landscape. And so those can be anything from thinking about climate, like temperature and precipitation, to landforms, like mountains or low-lying areas. In order to predict where biodiversity is high or where it is low, we need to have some understanding about what is driving those patterns. And as biologists, we can only go out and collect so many data points. It's very time-intensive and energy-intensive and costs money to get to all these places. So if we understand the relationship at a fundamental level between biodiversity and what we're terming geodiversity, we can actually interpolate and try to predict where biodiversity might be highest or lowest in areas that we don't have so much information about. So the project really relies a lot on NASA remotely sensed imagery, and those are huge files. And so we need to use the HPCC to be able to consolidate a lot of those data coming out of that and generate variables of interest for our work. We also use it to try and understand patterns of biodiversity, for instance, with trees or birds across the landscape. And those come in the form of point level data, which are usually collected by scientists in the field using a GPS. You know, I really fundamentally think that as humans, it is our role to try to understand and protect biodiversity because it provides so many functions that are essential for life on Earth. And so if I can do a little bit to help understand where biodiversity might be most at risk of climate change, I think that's going to be really helpful in a broader level.